fact, it is said that what you give your emotions to, what you give your attention to, is what becomes your reality. And it's interesting, as we start to notice what's around us and what it is that we're seeing, and the yogis say that we create our own reality, that we are the dreamer dreaming the dream. And so, I only know that you exist because I perceive you to exist, but in fact, this is all part of a dream that each of you has, that we are participating in. And what underlies that is that idea of love. He used to say that the hour, the moment of our death, when we pass from this plane, that the mystery of love is known. So at a festival like this, especially where we've got so much focused attention upon the realm of the heart, we've got lots of classes and workshops going on. There's lots of really neat things going on with connections and people, and the music especially, for me, is a really powerful motivator. All of that allows the energy to be focused back in the heart, because that's really where the spirit is. I think about where the energy is when we're connected to something we really love, we feel it. We don't feel it in our head. We feel it in our heart. That's why we say sweetheart, not sweet head. Oh, you are my sweet head. I love you so. So the beauty of the heart is that even children understand it. Every language understands it. Every country, every culture, the plants, the animals understand it. It's the oldest, most ancient language in the world. There's a really neat story that somebody shared with me about love, and it was about this lizard that they found when they had opened up a house that had been built, and they were going to open up the walls to build another part of the house, and when they took down the board of the wall, there was a lizard that was actually had its foot nailed into the wall, and he was there, he couldn't move, but he was alive. And apparently, as this person stood who had taken the board off the wall, wondering how did this lizard live there for so long, he saw another lizard come up and give it something to eat. I know, all right, aww, lizard love. And if anybody ever tells me that that was not a true story, I don't want to know that. The idea behind it, though, even if it isn't true, is that, you know, the right hand always helps the left. When the left lifts something heavy, the right doesn't sit there and think, well, do you need some help? Maybe you could pay me to help you this time. The right hand always helps out, left hand always helps out, and it's the idea of all of us in this dream that we are the dreamers of. So if we can make that garden of our mind, the garden that's full of flowers and the one that we would actually live in, because that's where that's your garden. So spend some time cultivating those thoughts that are beneficial to you. With that in mind, the next two chants we're going to do are actually Krishna chants.